Okay, we're gonna clear SSSS. SSSS, yes, finals. So I assume, like, we've done, like, what, 5 of these, and 3 of these have been the same time law. It's like they can't think of other time law or something, I don't know. But anyways, so this one is a little bit easier than the other ones. I'm gonna test out Ledin's 3C as well. So I think this, his 3C is gonna help people who are low power. It's gonna be really helpful. Let's go here. Didn't quite follow Matthew yet. So we're gonna place him here. Right like that. We'll go downwards. It we're gonna use that again real soon. Okay. As long as you're not in the range where they can hit you, and you're good. I mean the AoE. Just keep moving. 1, 2, 3. Since I have a lot of these, I'm just gonna use it. Oh, and with claw. Lucky. So we can kill her right after killing Amelia. I can't really go in, otherwise I'm too close and Egbert is going to go use his AoE. Oh, pop again. You don't have to worry about her, because she's pretty much forced to stay over here. I think that worked. And now, let's kill her. I'm gonna stay next to Matthew. Okay, so this is where Narm comes into play. So now I'm gonna reduce his mobility. And we can pretty much just kill Betty now. Oh, are you kidding me? Almost died here, oh my god. Okay, so last but not least, I think we can definitely kill now. Let's see how I want to do this. Like that. Flawless. Alright guys, if you're underpowered, I think this strat is definitely viable. So, give it a try. And if you don't understand how Ledin's 3C works, so definitely take a look at my breakdown video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.